nuns just died.
You do get that, don't you?
Mr. Hay, whilst I've every sympathy for your loss...
I've already told you, she just passed away in her sleep.
We'll have the toxicology report back in a matter of hours. It will prove if you're lying.
Look, whatever Tony Hutchinson has told you, it's a lie.
Let's go over your statement again, shall we?
We better find out whoever did this before I do. Otherwise, there'd be nothing left.
Just like them grapes.
I'll always eat when I'm worried, all right?
Can we all just calm down, okay? She's made of tough stuff, she's gonna be fine.
Yeah. That's right, innit, Paul?
John Paul's right, I'm sure she'll be fine.
Jim, thank you. You know, I'm scared to think what would have happened if you hadn't have been there.
I really didn't do anything.
Guys, guys.
Myra, sweetheart, can you hear me?
How is she?
Myra.
I can't believe you do this to him.
To who?
To Steve. How could you tell the police that he helped Pauline commit suicide?
Look, I haven't. I wouldn't do that to Steve.
Well, then if you haven't, then who has? Steve, are you okay? Did they let you go?
I've been released. Pending further inquiries. Could go to prison, Doug.
No, it's okay. Hey.
What are you doing here?
I'm so sorry, Steve. I didn't have any choice.
It was you that reported me. Cindy, is that true?
They want me to make a formal statement.
So, what are you going to tell them?
Only what I know. That Pauline was dying, but I didn't expect her to pass away so soon. Steve, if I ever have any suspicions, I have to report them.
Look, my mum wanted to die, right? I mean, what about me? What about my life?
Yeah, and I have a duty of care to protect those who need it. Look, all I can do is tell the truth.
I just hope you can live with whatever happens next.
They've asked us to step out for a minute so they can check on Myra.
Okay.
Come on now. Let's get you a cup of coffee.
You're coming.
I'll catch you up. I'll try and find out how she's getting on.
What are you doing?
Just making sure she's okay.
Oh. Myra, sweetheart, can you hear me? Don't just stand there, go and get help. Oh, Myra, my baby girl.
So, the next day, when you found out Pauline had died...
Well, it's not unheard of for patients to deteriorate quickly.
But you said in your initial statement... that you feared Mr. Hay would take matters into his own hands?
Well, I did. But I thought about it and I was mistaken. I read too much into it, that's all.
You also said Pauline Hay was incapable of administering her own medication. Is that still the case?
Like I said, I wasn't there.
That wasn't my question. In your professional opinion, was your patient capable of taking a fatal overdose by herself, or would she have needed help?
You rest up, okay? You'll probably get some clean clothes.
You're a miracle worker.
Oi, hands off you. He spoke before.
You really worried us, you know, man. Do you remember what happened?
You're out of danger now, but someone attacked you in the florist.
It was him.
Who?
Dr. Browning.
What, that got you to wake up?
No, that tried to kill her last night, wasn't it?
Steve, you know, you don't have to do this right now.
I could be getting locked up tomorrow, Doug, so if I don't do it, then we will.
What did the police say?
Doug, can you give us a minute?
Okay, yeah, I'll grab us some coffees. Just shout if you need me, okay?
Was she happy in the end?
Why do you care?
Because I need to know if it was worth it.
Please, can you just tell me what he said?
I told the police that your mum didn't need anyone's help in taking her own life. That she could have done it herself.
You lied. Why?
I was 10 when my gran died. She was living with us, but her mind had gone. My mum took care of her every day. Washed her, dressed her, made sure she ate. And all the time she kept fighting my mum off. Calling her all the names under the sun.
Why are you telling me this?
Because it still broke my mum's heart when she died. And seeing them both suffer like that, knowing there's nothing you can do to help, it's cruel.
Do you ever wish that you could have done more? To stop the suffering?
I was 10 years old.
Yeah, well, do you?
Just do me a favour, Esty. Sort your life out. No more drug deals. And keep hold of Doug. He really cares about you, you know.
Anything else?
Yeah. I'd go with the Oak.
It's like she was never here. You could always come back to mine. No, I just want to go to sleep. Okay. Doug, will you stay with me?
Yeah, sure, of course.
I mean, in there. No funny business, I just don't want to be alone.
Whatever you want. I'll just go see who that is.
See him. Stay. I didn't tell the police. I would never do that.
Yeah, we know. It was Sandy Roscoe.
I'm so sorry, Tony. I should have known it wasn't you.
I don't apologize. You were upset.
You still think I'm in the wrong, though?
Look, even though I don't agree with your decision, I do understand why you did it. And I care too much about you to see you put through any more pain.
Tell you what, we've come a long way, haven't we? Since I was that scrappy little kid in your kitchen.
Listen, Steve, I know she might not have always showed it, but you know your mum loved you, don't you? Come here.
She's really gone, hasn't she?